Hi everyone, Julie here from K&J Adventures, and today let's talk truck campers, my favorite subject. So what the heck is a truck camper anyways? Well, it fits in the back of a pickup truck, it's quite versatile, it has feet, not wheels, and most importantly, it can pretty much go anywhere that your pickup truck can go. Truck Camper magazine online states that truck campers make up 5% of the RV sales market. And a lot of today's truck camper manufacturers date all the way back to the 1950s and 60s when they started to come online sort of commercially for people's camping use. For example, the Northstar camper that I own has been built by the same family since 1961, and it's still constructed with wood as it was decades ago. So why a truck camper anyways? Well, they're cheaper than most RVs or travel trailers. There's no registration required. You don't even need a license plate. They're easy to park, easy to drive, easy to winterize, and you can store them in your driveway. You can access a lot of locations you might not be able to in a traditional, say, travel trailer or maybe a fifth wheel. They can be outfitted for four-season usage, and you can keep your pickup as your daily driver. Get, you know, pretty decent gas mileage with them as well. Okay, so what are some examples of today's truck camper models? Well, with a Google search, I came up with about 13 of them that are made in North America, and with a little bit of representation from each of the types. And for example, Lance is a truck camper company out of California that is the number one selling truck camper in North America. They were started in 1965. Again, they make hard side truck campers. And in 2016, Cruise America, the 1-800 RV rentals, actually had a Lance made for people to rent on a pickup truck. I saw it out in Utah last year traveling, and it's a great way to maybe check out a truck camper, you know, renting it instead of having to buy it. Alaskan truck camper is a really well-known one that's super cool because it's kind of half soft side, half hard side. It's a collapsible hard side camper. It's been built since 1953. In Washington, and it's wood framed. An example of a soft side camper would be the very popular Hallmark. They've been in business since 1969. They make only soft side campers. They're very versatile. They're built out in Colorado, and people really target these for off-road adventures because they collapse down. They have a low center of gravity. That's a great example of a pop-up soft-sided truck camper. And then Camp Lite, which is an aluminum framed camper, hard side. And something neat they did was in 2015, in conjunction with Ford's release of their all-aluminum body, they built a truck camper that's like the Ford, you know, Camp Lite truck camper. It's kind of cool. You'll see it on the road, and it has the Ford emblems and sort of Ford embroidery inside. So not bad if you're one of those Ford lovers, and not that there's anything wrong with that at all. Okay, so now let's talk more about the types of truck campers that are out there that you might be thinking about choosing. Let's start with a hard-sided truck camper versus a soft-sided truck camper. A soft-sided truck camper typically has an area that pops up when you're using the truck camper, like a foot and a half to 2 feet high, and collapses down when you're driving. So it tends to give you better gas mileage. It tends to be pretty stealthy, and it also is pretty compatible with like off-road use. Some people choose them strictly based on weight because they tend to be a lighter version and could be matched with, say, a half ton or a sport import pickup, like a Toyota Tacoma or a Nissan Frontier or something like that. And people would choose them for weight or for versatility. And with a hard side, of course, it's heavier. It's also probably quieter. It's also probably warmer. It's easy to access because you can just hop in the back at any point. You don't have to either put up the top or press up the top, which, just to let you know, is a very easy process in today's truck campers. And typically, a soft-sided camper might be also less expensive, but not always. They're pretty minimalist in their accessories inside, and a lot of them don't have kind of a standard bathroom and shower. They use kind of more of a porta-potty type scenario for a lot of the soft-sided truck campers. But again, not all. There's a couple of exceptions. So now let's talk about a basement model truck camper versus a non-basement. And I didn't know what the heck this was when I first started looking at truck campers, but the crux of it is when a truck camper slides into your truck bed, in a non-basement model, it sits between the wheels. That little 3.5-4 foot section, it slides right in there. And a basement model sits on top of the wheel well. So right away, you know that it's wider, it's taller. And also with the basement models, it's easier to access the cab over area. Let's say you have knee issues or some difficulty climbing up, it tends to be less of a step. The basement models also have some really pretty neat storage underneath them, because they kind of have that maybe 4.5 or 5 inches of the wheel well that actually becomes some kind of under storage. Fishing poles, awning cranks, all kinds of goodies could go under there. They ride higher. They tend not to have as good of a center of gravity, for example, as, you know, a non-basement or even a pop-up camper. And these models, some companies make basement and non-basement, some just make basement. And again, it's kind of a personal opinion because they're all engineered well today. But some people prefer to have the lower center of gravity and an overall smaller profile of a camper. And those are sort of the things that might lead you to a basement or a non-basement. Let's now talk about the framing and construction of today's most common truck campers. There's essentially three ways that they construct a truck camper today in the framing process. Some are framed with all aluminum, some are framed with aluminum and a little wood, maybe that's kind of the variable, all wood construction, and then Northern Lite makes a great truck camper that actually uses, they term it clamshell, and essentially it's kind of like a boat, two fiberglass molds put together, so you have no rubber roof, the seams are on the side, that one seam goes around. They're really well built in Canada and kind of recognized for their long-term, standing up to the elements. You pay for that though, so that also can figure into people's plans. You know, typically a wood frame truck camper does retail for a little less than some of the aluminum. So let's talk about the differences. Why would you think about going one way or the other? Wood is basically a good insulator. It keeps the camper warm, it keeps the camper pretty quiet, and you don't get that same experience with aluminum. It's a pretty traditional old school process, as you know, with like the old Airstreams and things like that. They're built with wood and then they wrapped them with that cool shiny aluminum. Who doesn't love an Airstream? Even a truck camper girl has to say that. So wood is porous and it doesn't really allow the material to get as much condensation inside as you might experience with an aluminum framed truck camper. It contracts and expands less in response to temperatures. Wood is, you know, cheaper to build with. It's typically cheaper to repair. Of course, if you have any water intrusion, you're definitely, you know, wood will rot. Aluminum will not rot. Aluminum is lighter than wood. And basically, a quality built camper today matters more than really what it's constructed of. But these things are sort of like, you know, the Chevy Ford Coke Pepsi argument. I think they're still building them in all three types of construction because there's a market for all of them. I'm not convinced one is definitely better than another. You may have your reasons for choosing, you know, one type over another. So let's talk about some other options that people might consider when they're interested in considering a truck camper as an RV purchase. So we also have bump out models in truck campers, and this is kind of a wild thing for a lot of people that like a simplistic truck camper, maybe an upgrade from a tent or things like that. But a bump out is a great addition if you have, you know, maybe more than two people, or you're going to have a guest there or a grandkid or something like that. And people really appreciate that it kind of gets some of the use of the camper out of the way so people can pass freely in between. The downside of bump outs in truck campers is that they have a lot of weight. They typically weigh at a minimum like 400 pounds. They would also take power to push out. So if you were boondocking or things like that, a bump out you might think, you know, is just not going to be good for your battery usage. However, they're built pretty well today. Years ago, people would avoid bump outs in RVs because they tended to be the real center for heat loss, as well as potential water intrusion and things like that. The most important thing with a bump out is that you're able to carry the extra weight that's going to add to the camper and put on top of your truck. I kind of like a simple truck camper, so for me the bump outs just weren't something I considered, but I think for some people they may be really an important part to getting the room they need inside a smaller truck camper. So the point of it is versatility. The only thing I don't like is if there's so many options on it, the truck camper weighs so much that you need like a 1 ton or more at a minimum to carry them. So weight would be a consideration too when you think about, do I want to slide out in my truck camper? So let's move on to holding tanks, bathroom configurations, cassette toilets, porta potties, or nothing at all. Now, the first thing people think about in a truck camper, if they are thinking about having a restroom and a shower, is will it be a wet bath or a dry bath? I think this one's kind of simple in my opinion, because think of a wet bath a lot like a boat. When you step into it, you're in this sort of fiberglass capsule, and it does include the toilet with a lid and maybe even a sink, but the shower is built right into it, so you kind of shower and clean that whole thing out every now and then. Advantages: it takes up less space, so you might gain an extra cabinet or two if you want to stick with a wet bath. A lot of people in truck campers use them, and most people really don't find anything different about them except for the concept that they don't look like a traditional bathroom in a regular travel trailer or, say, fifth wheel. And with a dry bath, you've got the separation. You have a shower stall with a curtain, and then you have your commode and, you know, your sink and all that. And that, again, might be great for a lot of people as far as accessing what they need, but you're going to lose some space, probably storage space, in the rest of the camper when you make a bigger bathroom. So you want to think in terms of wet bath, dry bath, and some people would prefer not to have one at all, which is really common in some of the pop-up versions. They have like a little cabinet that they basically store, you know, a Thetford, porta potty with a small, maybe couple of gallon tank. So some people, that's all they need. They might be showering outside. They might be, at a campground where they're going inside, and they don't want to take up space with a bathroom. So wet bath, dry bath, or none at all. So some pop-up models do have bathrooms in them, and some of them even have holding tanks, and some don't. So the thing to think about with those pop-ups, again, is they're kind of minimalist. They're lightweight. They're to get the job done. So now, the two types of porta-potties or bathrooms you're going to have if you choose one is either going to be a cassette toilet or what's called kind of the black holding tank method. There's advantages and disadvantages to both. Again, this is typically a personal opinion. A cassette toilet is a type of device that has a removable cartridge from the outside of the rig. It's portable, it's on wheels, it has a handle to pull it around, and typically it holds between 4 and 5 gallons, which for, you know, a couple of adults might go 2 to 3 days. Where can you dump it? Well, a lot more places than specifically a black tank. You can dump it into a traditional camp spot with the sewer intake, but you can also dump it into a porta potty, into a friend's house you're visiting on the road. I've pretty much dumped my cassette toilet everywhere that it's legal and legitimate, but they're very portable. You don't have to find a formal dump station in order to dispose of the waste. The disadvantages would be that they're not that big, 4.5 or 5 gallons. Again, for me, I find it easy because I have the camper off the truck. I might be going out for the day if I'm doing some boondocking, throw the cassette toilet reservoir onto the truck, and as I'm driving around, I may find a place that day just to dump it, so I don't have to go to a standardized dump station, which for me, I think that's freedom. But for a lot of people, that blank tank is basically underneath the camper. You don't really see it. They just call it black. It may be black and maybe white, and it can hold different volumes, you know, 10 gallons, 7 gallons, 15 gallons. In truck campers, I'm not sure how big they get. Maybe somebody can let me know with the big makers. But it could be maybe even as many as 15 gallons. So again, if you're boondocking, you're going to get a lot of use out of that kind of tank. And when you dump it, it's just like you do with other RVs. It has a little tank, you attach that hose, and you run it down into the sewer connector and you know, pull the tanks, as they say. So cassette toilet or a traditional holding tank is another decision to think about what might work best for you in a truck camper. I have to admit, I've become pretty fond of my cassette toilet in my Northstar camper, and I find it really easy to use, and mostly I like that I don't have to store that black water hose somewhere in my rig or my truck while I'm driving along the road. So take a look at the two different types of options and think about which one best suits your needs. So the other type of tank you're going to find on a lot of truck campers would be the gray water tank. And that typically involves your shower water and your sink water. And that's, of course, you know, not the black tank. If you use a soap like Dr. Bronner's, I learned about it online from somebody on YouTube, it's completely organic. It's like totally biodegradable, and it would allow you to dump your gray water anywhere. And that would mean that you could just pull that and put it in a field, your neighbor's lawn, in a parking lot, you know, it'd be just like adding water to something. So some people like, you know, keeping their gray water system clean. Again, boondockers that like to go pretty far out in their truck camper, they don't always have all the facilities that a campground would have. And so these things become important for the versatile truck camper type person. They want to have options. So the size of the gray tank might make a difference to you. And again, I encourage people to use biodegradable products. And so when they release those tanks, it does, you know, no harm to the environment. Another consideration would be about towing. In my case, one of the reasons and motivations I had for looking into a truck camper was because I wanted to tow my boat. And of course, that's a little hard to do unless you're in Idaho and Montana, where I love this. I see them on the highway. They've got like a guy pulling a fifth wheel with a boat attached to his fifth wheel, which is great because it's like the triple towing or double towing technically. And it's legal out in some of those states out west if it's like under 70 feet. But the rest of us out here, East Coast and a lot of other states, we don't have the option to, you know, tow as many things as we want on the back of our RV. So with the truck camper, it has pretty easy access to the hitch. And again, I say that part of the time because some truck campers extend up to 2 feet off the bed of the truck, which would mean you'd need something like a hitch extension. And that's not that difficult, but for myself, I just didn't see the need to it. I have a camper that comes right to the back and I can tow my boat very easily. And I also had to account for that, again, in the payload ratings and the weights, because adding something else I'm gonna pull with my truck counts into the figuring of having a, you know, safe and appropriate ride when you're carrying this this load. So if your truck camper choice is something that you may be looking for towing a razor, that would be awesome, towing a boat or towing any kind of storage, then you want to take a look at that back end of the camper and the size of it and how much clearance it gives you to get access to your hitch on the back of your pickup. So how about, depending on the type of truck you have, is there a truck camper out there that will fit the model that you have? Well, I can say it's very likely that's the case, because they make truck campers that fit 5.5 foot beds, 6.5 foot beds, 8 foot beds. Pretty much any kind of truck you have out there today in the US is going to be that there's a truck camper manufacturer that has one that fits it. Again, though, when I say fit, I remind you it has to do with your payload rating of your pickup and how much weight you're putting in it. But essentially, you know, the manufacturers account for all those different kind of trucks cruising around the roads in America. Regarding the pickup cab style, that's kind of a personal choice too. Maybe you already own a truck, maybe you're thinking about buying one, and you want to think about, you know, having sort of a single cab, double cab, crew cab, and how that affects the size of your bed, which therefore affects the size of the length and sometimes the width of the truck camper that you might be getting. So if you're buying two, you know, it's really a thought of matching what your needs are, storage needs inside the truck versus storage inside the camper, and putting a package together that really fits what you want to have. What are the general amenities available today in truck campers? Well, pretty much anything you can find in a traditional travel trailer or a fifth wheel, you're going to find in a truck camper. Like a stove and a bathroom, shower, microwave, heating, cooling, sleeping designs. They call them in the truck camper world north-south, which means that basically if one person wants to get out of the bed at night, they don't have to interrupt the other person to make their way into the cab area of the truck camper. And east-west is used for sideways sleeping. And again, the disadvantage, a person would be on the outside, would have to step over someone if they wanted to get up during the night to say, use the restroom. So there's the sleeping area. You got wet baths and dry baths and solar packages and dinettes and fireplaces and barca loungers and solar power generators. Anything you can pretty much think of in the big rigs is going to be in one form or another an available option in many of today's truck campers. My advice would be to go to a truck camper dealer near you, or try to find one maybe when you're traveling, and spend some time inside truck campers to see what it is that you might like or not like. And you might be surprised at what you find, that I think today a truck camper RV is an interesting option. So basically, I think you probably pick up on the fact that I think that a truck camper is a great option for travelers who are on the go. They like a simple and cost-effective rig, and they want to boondock and camp wherever their truck can go. I hope that some of this information is helpful to you if you're considering purchasing a truck camper, and maybe I got your attention enough for you to consider a truck camper as an RV option. I appreciate you watching my video, and happy camping.
Say something inspiring.
Who doesn't love truck campers? The Chevy Ford rivalry. Sorry, there's a bug in my glasses, and I will stop. So usually with these slide outs, a tip. Raise your hand if you love truck campers. And they want to boondock and camp where.
Some are framed with all aluminum. Some are framed with aluminum and a little wood. Maybe that's kind of the variable. All wood construction, and then.
It's okay.